keep them going. Thick wheels rolling, moving on. The white line is the lifeline to a nation. And men like Will and Sonny make it move. A good hot cup of coffee is waiting up ahead. And the rhythm of the highway hums along. Jamming gears has got to be a fever. Cause men become addicted to the grind. It takes a special breed to be a truck driving man. And a steady hand to pull that load behind. Big wheels rolling, gotta keep them going. Big wheels rolling, moving on.
The whole wide world's my home. Here, honey lamb. I'm sorry, it's just this little bit of nothing, but you can't expect the stove to be working under these conditions.
I'm not hungry, Mom. Save it for Billy.
Let me see something. You ain't got no fever, but you're hurting, ain't you?
I've been hurting ever since you made up your mind to leave Arkansas and come clear to forever. Well, we don't know a soul.
Mobile is not forever. It's a new life and a fresh start, and mostly it's a place where we're going to have some land of our own.
I never seen it, and I hate it. We should have stayed with folks we know.
I never seen it, and I hate it.
Living on somebody else's place, making do without your daddy.
You're wrong, Mom.
If I'm wrong, I'm entitled.
I thought we were all supposed to have our say in this family.
That's right, and you've had yours over and again.
And now I've had it, you're going to make up your mind and do just like you wanted to do before.
You got it right. Wake up, little girl. There's a whole wide world waiting for you out here. Breathe some fresh air into your life.
Big 18-wheeler, full of explosives, bearing down on me. I mean, he was really modoc, and he must have been doing 80 miles an hour. The brakes are gone. Well, I couldn't get out of his way because the road was too narrow.
What did you do?
Yeah, Sonny, what did you do?
Well, I jammed the rig in reverse and backed away from it.
At 80 miles an hour?
Yep. I let him come to me, and then I brought him down with my brakes.
Wow.
Wow, double wow.
Did they give you a medal, Sonny?
Just a little one.
Oh, come on, Sonny. Show him the medal.
Please?
It's right in here,
Sonny. I don't have it with me anymore. Oh. I gave it to a guy that saved my life when I was hauling a tanker full of high octane and it caught fire.
Pruitt, please. A meal is as good as a feast.
Too much, huh?
I can't hardly wait till I'm a trucker.
Thought you were going to be a farmer.
Oh, that was before I met you and Sonny. Now I'm going to be a truck driver.
Every boy wants to be a trucker at least once in a while.
I didn't. I never did.
That's because you didn't grow up on a farm. I mean, you stand there and you watch those big rigs going by on a highway and you think, I wonder what they're hauling. I wonder where they're heading. I wonder if I'll ever head there myself.
I'm going to see it all from my rig once I get Mom and Ellen settled in our new place and I get all grown up.
Pruitt, are you sure you know where this farm is?
Just following the directions. Dauphin. Dauphin Street?
Yeah. Billy, you ever been to this farm before?
No, sir. We didn't even know we owned the land until after Dad died. Then Mom found out about it in his papers. It was my great-great-grandpa's land. 4 or 5 great schools. It was his land.
Well, pretty soon you're going to clap eyes on 4 or 5 great-grandfather's pieces of land.
Well, it's just every bit as pretty as I imagined it'd be.
Mm-hmm. Well, what do you fellas think?
Annie, I think you got your wires crossed.
This is a public park.
No, sir. Yeah. This is my husband's great-great-great-great-grandpa's place. Yeah. Look it. Even got his name over there. Even if they don't know how to spell it right.
No, that's Bienville. Your name is Bienville. B-E-A-N.
Thank you very kindly. I know how to spell my own name. Listen, all them French names, they got changed around somehow because folks that couldn't pronounce them right or spell them or whatever.
She's right there.
Of course I'm right. Hey, listen, we're going to set the house down right over yonder, right between them two big trees.
Honey, Will may be right, Mom. Looks like a public park to me.
Well, sure it does, honey lamb. I've no objection to these folks using it up to now. They really fixed it up. But you know, all them little squirrels running around, we're going to have to fence around when we start to plant.
There's got to be some mistake. This is the center of Mobile.
Well, it weren't that way when Jeff's great-great-great-great-grandpa had it a long time ago. The way the stories is handed down is just meadows and trees from here to evermore. You know, I thought that's just what it was anymore, just stories, till I found those papers after Jeff died.
Yeah, do something, huh?
You
tell her. Tell her that she cannot put it down here.
You tell her.
I told her already.
Well, tell her again.
You're the lawyer. You tell her.
Oh, no, you've got to explain.
I don't think you're going to have to.
Okay. Who owns that rig parked back there?
I do, officer.
You want to move it, or am I going to ticket you?
No, it's my fault, officer. Sonny, if you just pull her in and unhitch her, we'll just set her down yonder between them two big trees.
Oh, now, come on, folks. I've had a long day.
This is no joke.
Okay, I'm not joking either. Let me see a license.
Officer, I might just have to ask you to get off my property.
Your property? What is she talking about?
This lady hired us to deliver that mobile home to the site that she selected. And this is the site she selected.
You see, the state gave this parcel of land to my husband's... to one of my husband's forebears, about 200 years ago. Only it wasn't even a state then. It's hardly even a country.
What are you, lady? Some kind of bicentennial nut?
Don't call my mom a nut.
Oh, well, I'm sorry. I apologize.
No, that's all right. That's all right. Look, I'm just going to tell you how it is for once and good, all right?
Yeah, do that.
All right. Now, they gave all of this to one of my husband's kin because he founded Mobile before he went on to found New Orleans. Now, not that it's any of your beeswax, but after Jeff died, that's my husband, the insurance money I bought this mobile home with, and then I just decided to pick up sticks, and here we are.
Well, I think it's time for you to pick up sticks again and clear out of here, ladies.
Ma, I told you how folks would be here. We better go.
We ain't going no place.
How about city jail, lady?
Oh, officer, could I speak to you in my chambers?
Officer, could you give us
an hour? Just need an hour.
What for?
What for? To get her out of your hair and to get her to come off of this. Because if you don't stop giving her pressure, she's going to bring us all to grief.
She'll get her back up.
1 hour.
That's it. Just an hour. Please.
And then you'll tow that house out of here?
Oh, absolutely. Promise.
Cross heart.
Okay. You got
thank
it.
Thank you. Thank
you. Oh, yeah.
Okay, Annie, what do you want to do?
Well, I tell you what I want to do. Set her down over yonder.
I can't set her down over yonder. You just heard Smokey.
Oh, it ain't his fault. He just don't understand this is Bienville land yet, that's all. Well,
maybe it was Bienville land a long time ago, but not any longer.
Listen. I want to thank you two fellas for toting our house. You did it fine. You did it real fine, and I'm grateful. We're all really grateful. And if you'll just bring her in here and set her down, you can be on your way. Unless, of course, you want to stay and have something to eat with us. We owe you that much for sure and certain.
Ellen, you can
convince your mother?
No, sir. Not if her mind's set.
I hate to do this to you, Annie, but you gotta see it from my side. I can't drop your house here because that's against the law. I'm gonna have to drive it someplace else and drop it.
Sonny, that's my house. You ain't gonna lay one hand on that Sonny Pruitt, at least I say so.
That is my rig that is connected to your
that
house.
That don't make no difference. If you'll just set her down like I told you to, there ain't gonna be no problem.
Annie, you're not even listening.
Annie, me like I'm one of them city women. Likely as not, I'll be tempted to go in there and get my gun and drive you off here with a load of buckshot
this
in your britches.
This is not your property.
This is my property. Hey.
Well, don't let her yell at me.
Folks.
What?
Folks.
Just jump ball.
Thank you.
Suppose I could convince you legally that this was not your property.
Yeah, suppose
it. Judge, that'd be impossible.
Okay, but humor me. Suppose I could.
Well, we move on. There ain't nothing I hate worse than squatters.
Okay. Let me have that piece of paper.
What piece of paper?
The title deed says that you found in your husband's belongings.
Now, be careful. It's real old and crumbling.
What do you plan to do?
I'm going to take this to City Hall and check it against the records.
Good thinking.
Can I go with you?
No.
No, you stay here and keep my seat warm. But you're coming with me.
Billy, honey?
Yeah?
You rode up there with them two fellas a couple of times. How much difference is it driving that thing to driving a tractor?
There's a lot of difference.
Yeah?
It's got 10 gears for one thing.
Mom, oh, yeah? I know what you're thinking, and it won't do.
Mom, Ellen's right. It just won't do.
Please, Mom.
Leave her be. She can't drive it no how.
What do you know? Annie's husband's kin did find Mobile.
Well, even if it is her kin, we don't have time for that. Come on.
You're wasting your time, you know. You're not only wasting your time, you're wasting my time.
If I can get Annie to accept the inevitable, I'm not wasting anybody's time.
You couldn't get Annie to accept Judgment Day if she's not ready for it. I tell you, in my whole life, I've never met a more stubborn individual.
I have.
Yeah, who? Come on, I'm not stubborn.
Don't get much call for these old records. And it's a pity, because history of the whole region's all in there. The Reeds, the Fauntleroys, the Barraclows, all there wheeling and dealing, what they owned, how many slaves. Original land grants, deeds, titles, all in there. Nobody much knows or cares.
We're looking for something in the 1700s, Mr. Henway.
Let me know exactly what you're looking for, and maybe I can help.
Bienville Square. Title. Who owns it?
The city.
Must be a title to it, huh?
Well, certainly.
That's what we're looking for.
That's what you're looking for. That's what I'll find for you. You want to call back?
Yeah, when?
Well, sometime next week.
How about tonight? It's urgent.
Well, I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll start the search right away. Just as soon as I come up with something, I'll let you know. Where can I contact you?
Bienville Square.
And where else? Don't forget the nuts.
The Henways.
Won't work. What do you mean it won't work? We just find a parking lot that will take it, we drop the trailer there, and then we take off.
She won't do it.
Well, I'm not going to leave my rig parked out on the street all night.
That's for certain. A cop only gave you.
No. Pardon us, please. Pardon us, please.
Please. Sorry.
Hey, where are you fellas? Oh, it's you. You're under arrest.
Officer, let me say one thing. You're making a terrible mistake.
You ain't just a kidding, buddy. When the sergeant gets here, you're gonna find out.
Two more minutes. Just two.
You already had an hour.
What difference is 2 minutes gonna make?
Okay, but just till the sergeant gets here, then you're all gonna wind up in jail.
Psst. What are you doing up there, Billy?
Standing guard. But you fellas should go in.
Thanks.
First they move my rig without my say-so, then they give me permission to visit it. Those Beanvilles are something else.
All to the earth.
You know what? If that Annie were a man,
no,
I would...
She isn't, and you're not.
Will you look at that? My rig.
I moved my house.
You had to drive my rig to do it.
I couldn't hardly carry it on my back. Now sit down and have some dinner. There's plenty for everybody.
We're all gonna end up in jail. You know that, don't you?
Since when can a body be jailed for settling his own land?
It ain't. I give up. I just flat give up.
Well, you didn't find nothing to disprove my claim, did you?
No, not yet I didn't.
You're not going to, neither. I could have told you that from the start.
What's Billy doing up in the bandstand?
Garden.
Oh, baby.
Garden?
I forgot all about him. Here, honey, take him up some food.
Well, why don't we call him in for it, Mom?
No, darling. He's the man of the house since your daddy died. And he feels like he's acting out like it out there.
Okay.
Let him be. Sit down.
I'm not hungry.
Again, of course you are, a big man like you. They're always hungry. Sit down. Come on, Will. Here, sit. I ain't hardly got the hang of this cooker yet. As soon as I do, I'll fix you something better. But it's hot and it's nourishing.
Electricity, Annie. You are stealing electricity.
Oh, I don't see it that way. Now, sit down and eat. The way I see it is somebody saw fit to put a lamp post on my property without my permission, and they just deserve anything they get.
Mom, the police are coming.
All right, okay, let's back it up, please.
Put your back.
Let's go home.
Back it up.
This is a public car.
I'm aware of that, sir. Now, go home.
I know my rights.
And I know my job, and I'm trying to do it. Now, please go home.
Excuse me, officer. What's the problem?
Is that yours?
It sure is.
Then you're under arrest.
Oh, wait a minute.
You too.
Look, this is my rig that's connected.
Then you're in trouble, too.
What is the charge?
Are you kidding? It'd take 10 minutes to read them all.
I'm Mrs. Beanville's attorney, and I want to hear them.
Okay, trespassing, maintaining a nuisance, violation of motor vehicle laws, appropriation of public facilities. That enough?
Will, I'm real grateful, but I don't have no money for no lawyer. And besides, I don't need one. This is my land. That's all there is to it. Now, listen. If you fellas got some lawful business with me, that's okay. Otherwise, I think you better get off my land before you do something you're going to be real sorry for.
Fruitcakes. We get them all the time. You from California?
Arkansas.
I'm sorry, lady. If you don't move that rig, I'm going to have to take you in. You know what you can get for assault and arson, mister?
No, and I don't want to know.
Would you like to go with the lady?
Would you like me to call my cousin in the state legislature?
You do that from jail, fella. Hands behind your
back. What are you doing? What's going on?
We're trying to keep everything cool. You do that one more time, I'm going to run you in.
Now you all do like I say and go on clear off my land.
Okay, lady. Put the gun down before you hurt yourself.
Please, Mom, don't.
Don't me. I ain't putting down nothing till everybody clears off my land.
Mr. Chandler. There you are. You were right, Mr. Chandler. Absolutely right. Once you told me what to look for, I found it right away. Which one of you people is Mr. Bienville?
Mrs. Bienville. My husband's dead. I'm Annie Bienville.
Mrs. Bienville? City Hall is in a complete uproar about all this. They've already called a special meeting.
Hey, fella, who are you?
Victor Henway.
Okay, Henway, what's this all about?
He's from the City Hall. He works for the Bureau of Records.
Good. Maybe you can explain to these fruitcakes they're trespassing.
Yes, right away. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm afraid that you are all on private property.
Not them, Henway. The lady over there.
But she's not.
Not what?
Not trespassing. We're the trespassers, all of us.
It must be the time of the year. Now we've got another fruitcake.
You don't understand, Sergeant. This is their property, the Bienville's. It was granted to an Henri Bienville by the City Fathers 180 years ago, and to his direct descendants in perpetuity.
Your Honor, since it is the Beanville's land, and we were acting in accordance with our contract to deliver the residence to said premises, Therefore, I believe that delivery was legal, and I believe the city cannot prohibit us from removing our truck from said premises.
We appreciate your point of view, Mr. Chandler, but you're a practical man, and you must realize, with your legal background, that the first obligation of government is to protect all of its citizens.
Yes, and the Beanvilles are now citizens of Mobile.
And we welcome them to Mobile, but we are not going to deed them land in the center of our city.
We have the deed.
We don't accept that. Until we find a way to deal with this situation, your truck will remain where it is.
Your Honor, thank you.
Hi, Chief.
Hey, how'd it go?
Right now, the commissioner and the mayor are in a big huddle.
What are you doing out here?
Recessed for lunch.
Oh, that's great. Here's a citizen bleeding to death. They're taking a break for lunch. Look, can I take my truck out of the park?
No, if you do, they're going to impound it.
Well, why, for Pete's sake?
Because right now, you're number two on their list. If you hadn't brought that Mobile headache into town, they...
Look, I was just doing what I got paid for.
I explained that, Pruitt. Right now, they're trying to find a way to sue you for disfiguring city property.
Okay. You go back up there and you tell them that one way or the other, I am taking my truck out of that park tomorrow, and if they try to impound it, I'll... impound them. And get your shoes shined.
Sure don't seem right having to fence this in. Folks ain't gonna have no place to walk the kids or sit in the shade.
Better than have them stomp all over our crop. It's our land, and we gotta take care of it.
Oh, your daddy'd been so proud of you.
I'm proud of you, Ma.
You and Billy.
Hey.
That's Beanville.
That's me.
I'm Liz Mundy. I'm from the electric company.
Oh, well, nice to meet you, Liz. Just call me Annie. This is Ellen.
How do you do?
Now, what can we do for you?
Well, it's been brought to our attention that you've been tapping electricity from one of our city lamps.
Yeah, that's right. It ain't very efficient, but it'll do if you put us a regular supply in.
But I don't think you understand, Miss Annie. We realize that through some technical mishap, you've laid temporary claim to this parcel of city land. But as far as we're concerned, what you're doing is illegal. And unless you stop immediately, we'll be forced to take action in court.
Well, you do that, and then we'll just have to take up the little matter of rent while we're in court.
What rent?
Well, I counted, and there are about 10 lampposts you got stuck in here around the square on my property. And I figured rent at $1 a lamppost, and that comes to $10 a week. Now, you backdate that to whenever y'all put them in. I ain't much good with figures, but that sounds like a pile of money to me.
Don't forget about the water, Ma.
That's right. And hey, I don't stand there holding them things. Put them over there. Are you folks, do you look after the water, too?
Yes, ma'am. Water and power.
Oh, that's good. Listen, we'd like to tap into that fire hydrant over yonder. We need plenty of water for planting and for home use. So we'd be real obliged if you just shut the pressure off tomorrow. Even just for a couple hours, and Ellen and me, we can get our plumbing in.
Annie, confidentially, I think you're terrific.
Well, I...
But you know it's my job, and I must...
I know, honey. I know. I understand. I just want you to go tell your boss. See, if he's got any water or power lines in and under here, you know, that we have to make some kind of arrangement. Things like that, they have to be paid for, now, don't they?
Oh, I'll tell him, Annie. Word of honor. You're something. Really something.
Well, that's neighborly of you.
Well, good luck to you.
Thank you. Hey, Sonny, why don't you meet Liz? This is Liz Mundy from the Water and Power folks, and she's good people.
I do.
Hello there. Hello there.
She's going to take and turn the water off tomorrow for a couple hours so me and Ellen can get our plumbing in.
Yeah, that's great.
Well, we're going to put in a request, and we'll see what happens.
Yeah. And if you're around tonight around dinner time, just drop in for some potluck. We're much obliged to you.
Thanks, Annie. I'll see. Welcome to Mobile.
Oh, thank you. We like it. Well, what's happening down at City Hall? You still running around with chickens with heads cut off?
Yeah, it looks that way. Tell you what, Annie, I'm going to haul my rig out of here tomorrow.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What are you going to do if they impound it like they say?
Might as well. It's not doing me any good sitting here.
Well, I sure got you in a bind, didn't I? You must think I'm a pig-headed, stubborn somebody, rather.
You're just doing what you think is right.
I don't know how right it is. Other folks getting hurt. Whatever happens. Oh, it'll work out, Sonny. It'll work out. It'll work out.
Well, I hope we just don't sit around and starve to death.
Well, you ain't gonna starve. Not with me around. Come on.
Thought you'd never ask.
You wrap your stomach around that, you'll feel better.
It's not going to work out, Annie. You realize that.
It already has eat your dinner.
Right now, down at City Hall, they are all running around in circles trying to figure out some scheme to get rid of you.
Oh, they're just a whistling in the wind.
Mm-hmm. Don't you believe it. I have had dealings with the government before. They have everything covered by rules and regulations, and if they can't find the regulation they need, they go out and make one up. You'll see.
Well, there's got to be some way to make him understand, Sonny.
Yeah, you got to get the people on your side. You got to attract the public's attention.
How you going to do that?
I don't know. Climb up on top of the battleship Alabama and threaten to jump off.
Ticket?
Yes, sir.
You got to go back to the gift shop and get a ticket. Want a tour of the Alabama? It'll cost you $2.
I don't want a tour or anything. I just want to go to the very top.
Why do you want to go all the way up there?
So as I can, attract the public's attention.
Well, if it wouldn't attract my boss's attention, I'd let you in, son. Well, I can't do it.
Yes, sir. Thank you anyway. I'll be back.
Everyone's been blue. A pretty color, baby. When it's worn by you, it's okay. Lose your way, my love. We've all been lonely too. It's okay to be the way you are, no matter what you do.
Miss Bienville?
That's me.
I'm from City Hall, tax collector's office.
Is that right?
Yes, ma'am. I have a property tax demand for you.
Well, hand it over. I always pay my taxes.
There may be an error, a couple of dollars. Our computer's not programmed to deal with calculations like this one.
Well, which end's up?
In your hand there. The grand total is at the top. We've computed the taxes from the date of the original land grant, with the customary late payment penalties being added in and compounded.
That's, 3,684,932.
Give or take a couple of dollars, you have 24 hours in which to pay.
Are you joshing me, mister?
No, ma'am. If you don't pay within 24 hours, you'll be served with a notice to quit. Good day to you.
Lordy.
Thanks.
Sonny?
Oh, thank you, huh?
Should have said where we was at.
Yeah. Well, it sure looks like I made a mess of everything. Trouble was, I thought it was for the best. I really did.
You're just gonna have to find another piece of land, Annie.
Yeah. Finding it easy, it's a pain, it's hard.
What's he gonna do, Sonny?
Ask the lawyer. He's got a plan.
It's me. I'm going to Montgomery. Got an appointment in the governor's office.
Give him my regards.
Got a better idea?
Yeah, I got a better idea. You want something done, you go to the people. You don't go to the government.
Government is the people.
Well, I never heard of the people declaring war, the people raising taxes. You want to go whack your brains out, Montgomery, okay. I got better things to do.
Like circulating a petition?
Well, if I had time, I'd do that. But since I don't have time, I'm going to do the next best thing. Now, you want to go whistling in the wind, go ahead and just have a good trip.
I swear I can't figure him. I just can't. Yesterday, he couldn't wait to get shed of the house and me. And today, it's just about the most important thing in his whole entire life.
That's the way he is. I'll see you later. I gotta catch a bus.
Have a good trip.
Hey, Will, where are you going?
Hey, how are I gonna make a short trip?
Is they gonna run us off by land?
They're trying.
I knew they would. Can you get me along?
$2?
What for?
I need it real bad. It's for Mom and Ellen.
Okay, here's the dollar, 40, dollar 50. All right, hold on. And that makes two. Okay.
You're a nickel short.
I'm not a nickel short. I just put it. Ah. All right. Hold everything. Only got my bus fare. And okay.
Right.
Right.
Goodbye.
The thing of it is, the land really is hers. I mean, it's been in her husband's family since forever. Now, when they found out they couldn't do anything about it, they slapped her with a tax bill that even an Arab couldn't afford.
They'll get you every time.
Gave her 24 hours. If she wills it back to the city, and if she clears out, then they waive the tax bill.
They're all hard.
Which means that she's got no place to go and no bread if she had someplace.
I've got a brother-in-law at the TV station. He owes me plenty. I'll give him the pitch, and I'll guarantee he'll put it on the news.
That's what we need. Get it to the people, and the people will get with it.
Well, my kids are in that Spirit of Mobile band. Why, there's 175 of them. They'll help us out. Then there's the Azalea Trail Maids.
Yeah, but what about the Lion, the Kiwanis, and the Rotary?
What about them? I mean, you can't expect somebody else to do your job. You got to do it. Get to them. Let's get the people with it. Help Annie. Not just city employees, you're citizens of Mobile. So what you do in your off-duty hours, that's your own business, right?
Right. I'll get on the phone. Count on me. We can use the old engine number 4.
Yeah, Paul's the place for it.
Yeah.
We'll just take it down there.
Yeah.
Oh, all right, that too, yeah.
Joking. Then I remembered the name, Bienville. You know, those are the folks who have had all those troubles. And so I went out looking for him, and I saw him going up there.
You can man the phones, use the radios. You can get to all those politicians that owe you their jobs and just, well, in general, pass the word.
Hey, Mr. Pruitt.
Yeah?
You're all tangled up with the Bienville family, aren't you?
It's just what I was telling the guys.
We just picked up a call on the police band. Kid by the name of Bienville is going to take a hitter off the USS Alabama. We're going to go over. Want to come along?
The mother coming now. I'll try to get a word
please,
from her.
Please, not now. Please.
Miss Bienville, he won't come down. He says the city hall don't let you stay where you folks are at. He's gonna jump.
I'm gonna paddle his hide. That's what I'm gonna do. Billy! Can you hear me? You come down from there right now, Billy!
Billy!
Bill, Bienville! You're gonna get whooped for this! Please, Billy! Please don't move!
He'll come down, Annie. He's just scared. Has anybody tried to talk him down?
He won't let nobody near him. I got maybe 40 feet. He said if I got any closer, he'd jump.
Oh, Lord, I'm going up there.
No, Mom. This time I'm not going.
No, Mama Me.
You're not going no place.
I'm going up there.
How do I get up there?
Follow me.
Hang on to her.
Hang on, Billy. Sonny's coming.
Miss Bienville, is it true that your son will jump if you're not allowed to stay in Bienville Square?
Oh, Lord, May, I don't know. I don't know.
Hear that, folks? These people are direct descendants of the fine men who founded our fair city.
And now they're being hounded by the elected officials of that self-same city.
Bill boy. Well, that's quite a climb, isn't it? But it's worth it, huh? I can see why you came up here. I bet nobody's ever had this view of Mobile before, huh?
Don't come over here.
Oh, okay. Just let me get my breath and then we'll both go down, huh?
I ain't going down.
You can't very well stay up here.
Don't!
Come on, Billy. Your mom and Ellen and Willamy got enough problems. And if you don't come down with me, that means that I'll have to go down all by myself. And I tell you, the thought of that just plain scares me to death.
You ain't scared of nothing.
You want to bet?
Really scared?
Count on it. I'll tell you a secret. I am more scared right now than I've ever been in my life. And if you don't help me down, we just may stay up here until kingdom come.
I can't. Not unless they let us stay in our new farm.
This won't help, Billy. Believe me.
It'll attract the public's attention. That's what you said. And now you're telling me to believe something else?
Should have kept my mouth shut. There are other ways of attracting the public's attention. Billy, better ways.
Honest?
Listen, what about this? What about if I promise to really attract the public's attention? Would you help me down then?
You're honestly scared to go down by yourself?
Hey, guy, I'm honestly scared. I've been afraid of being up high all my life.
And you came up anyway?
Well?
Then I guess I'll have to. Don't be afraid, Sonny. Come on.
This is Mr. Pruitt, folks.
Pruitt.
Mr. Pruitt, right. The gallant truck driver who just risked his life to save the little boy. I tell you, Mr. Pruitt, all of Mobile was up there with you. We were all down here rooting for you to pull it off.
Well, then, if maybe everybody out there would start rooting for the whole Bienville family, then maybe somebody would come up with a solution to this problem.
Thank you very much, Mr. Pruitt.
Just take a minute. Annie, come here a minute. Annie, listen, come here. Here, take this and tell the people in Mobile all about yourself. Go on.
Well, okay, go ahead, Miss Bienville.
Well, first of all, what I want to say is thank you. Thank you to Sonny Pruitt for getting our Billy down off there. Well, it sure gave me a fright.
Oh, and then I'd like to thank all of you good people of Mobile, Alabama. You're really fine folks. Just every, everybody we met has just been so nice and just so interested in our problem and all.
And, you know, even those folks at City Hall, they're just trying to do what you elected them to do. They're just trying to take care of this city best as they know how. Of course, we're real disappointed, you know, because we ain't got no place to go, but, oh, that's okay. We'll make out. We always have. And just as long as we got each other and friends like our two truckers and a good health. I mean, what more can a family ask? Well, thank you. Thank you very much. And thank you very kindly, too. Well, we got to get on back over the house because we're going to move on out tomorrow morning.
Uh-huh. Thank you very much, Miss Bienville. And now we return you to our WALA-TV Channel 10 studios.
Bye.
Everybody.
Hey, Sonny, we're doing fine, but we need about 10 more minutes. We want to pack the best china and get those ornaments off the tree so they don't break on the trip. Now, you're an odd one, Sonny Pruitt, I'll tell you true. First is hurry up and get out, and now it's plenty of time.
Can I have a cup of coffee?
Sure, help yourself.
Do I hear a marching band?
Mom, can I go see? All right, honey, but don't go far. We're going to leave in a precious few minutes. Right? Let me help you, sugar. Go faster. Mom, come quick. Baby, we're busy. We got to pack.
Mom, just got to come see us. They've got our name on the banner.
It's the Bienville Fair for the benefit and future well-being of the Bienville family. And you know what? They're going to take up a collection to buy you some land to put your house on.
Oh! Oh, no! Oh.
But who done all this?
The city of Mobile. And they did it all overnight. Doyle, Mr. Mims.
Howdy.
And
how are
you? This is Mrs. Watkins.
Hello.
Special representative.
Nice to meet you. How are
from,
you?
From Montgomery.
Hello. The governor asked me to fly down with Mr. Chandler to welcome you to Alabama and to tell you that he's talked to Mayor Doyle and all charges against you have been dropped.
Well, I declare. She funning me? Are you funning me?
No, all charges have been dropped.
Lordy. Oh, and me looking like a dish rag.
Ha,
This is what happens when the people get together. Right, guy, you see what I mean? If you want action, you go to the people.
I went to the government.
Pruitt.
I got action, too.
Okay, so we're both right, but I'm righter than you are. You know what the kicker is? All these people contributed money to buy her land to put this house on.
I got a kicker, too.
What's your kicker?
I'm not going to tell you, because you wouldn't believe me. Not in a million years.
Well, just try me, huh?
I'm going to the fair.
Now listen, guy. We have got to haul out of here in 2 hours.
Well, first we got to take the Bienville's place back.
No, that's all taken care of. The commissioner said that the city's going to do it.
I sure hope that government researcher in Montgomery keeps his mouth shut.
What's the researcher got to do with it?
It's a kicker I was going to tell you.
That you're not going to tell me?
Yeah.
So tell me.
This government researcher, he burrowed around in the archives. And guess what he found?
I don't want to guess what he found. Tell me.
Henri Bienville, founder of the city of Mobile, former owner of this choice little piece of real estate, had two sons. Now, these two sons both married at a very early age. That's the sort of thing they did.
All right, go on, tell me.
They died about age 65, 68, thereabouts, without issue.
What do you mean, died without issue?
You're kidding me, without any children.
Then Annie's husband wasn't a Bienville.
Bienville, oui. Bienville, no.
You mean he didn't inherit the property? Never.
Jamais. This piece of paper came from a mail order house.
That old man sent in $10, and they sent him a piece of paper proving that the Bienvilles were his ancestors.
You've got to be kidding.
Now, may I go to the fair?
You may go to the fair, and you may have fun.
Thank you.
Thank you.